Your intros lately have been
Great.
They've been disturbing.
I mean, they're really, not disturbing. No, they've been fantastic.
I mean, yesterday's intro was, I thought was really bad.
Well, those guys liked it. The whole racial profiling joke.
All right.
Well, fine. Here we go again.
All right. But let's see what you got for David.
Okay. Well, if you believe what BJ says, the only person that's creepier than the character our next guest played on Boston Legal would be yours truly. Please welcome to the show the Grand Marshal of the Gay Pride Parade, David Dean Bottrell.
Hey, guys.
Is that all right?
You know what? Actually, that's a very good intro because you two run neck and neck.
Oh, thanks.
But I still think you're creepier than Lincoln Meyer was on Boston Legal. And
awesome.
Lincoln Meyer was a whack job, too. Let me tell you, he really was. And David, great job, because as I've just been speaking with you in studio, you know, because all I know you from, because that's the first time I've really become in contact with you,
right,
is that character.
Right.
And he really was. It was a great creepy, but very intelligent. And almost you wonder, maybe he's just eccentric and not a whack job. But you know how David Kelly goes. If you're going to come back on the show, you have to really ramp it up in the whack job.
Absolutely, man. I don't think I've ever seen a character like Lincoln on TV, like, ever.
It was
the first time, man.
That was awesome. And it culminated in him holding Candace Bergen's character hostage with a bow and arrow, like a rigged up bow and arrow. If you open the door, she gets impaled by an arrow.
Yeah.
I mean, it was just the weirdest.
It was amazing.
It was the most bizarre hostage situation I had ever seen. And we never really got to know and even though his character was very prim, proper, slightly effeminate, we never really knew the orientation of him because he seemed to be fascinated with women. He was a peeping Tom.
Absolutely.
Guy.
Absolutely. He's really ambiguous. And yeah. I think it's how people were really kind of fascinated by
it. Yeah, it was a great job because he was,
thanks.
And you sound nothing like him. And sometimes when you see guys,
that's a good thing, huh?
Well, I guess so. But it really, you convinced me. Like, wow, this guy, whoever this actor is, he's probably that guy. that's brutal. So, David Dean Bottrell in the studio, and of course, you're the Grand Marshal of our Gay Pride celebration. Here in town, which they almost didn't have one. I don't know if they told you.
Yeah, no, I didn't hear about that.
Well, they tried to take it to a different location last year.
Right.
There's a predominantly gay section of our town, and there's a main street where they usually have it, where they're
right.
going to have it again.
Right.
They decided to go to where the basketball arena is. There's a huge carnival-like area with rides and, you know, playhouses, and it's a pretty big attraction
right.
Called Seattle Center, and they took it down there, which is where they hold a lot of festivals and music festivals and things like that we have
right.
here. But it costs a little money for them to do that, more than they expected. And they got a little, did they go bankrupt?
Yeah,
or?
A little low on the loot, yeah, I think. Yeah.
And so it almost really jeopardized the tradition. And
okay.
Now here it is. They got enough money to get you here, or is this a volunteer? How does it work to get like a Grand Marshal guy to come out?
Okay, so I got here yesterday. So I know nothing about this previous controversy, but I know that the thing that I'm doing is the Seattle Pride March, which is different than the parade, because I'm on Saturday and then the parade's on Sunday.
Oh, really?
And this march is in the old neighborhood, I think on Capitol Hill, right?
Yeah, that's the one. That's okay. the one I'm talking
so
about.
So we're on
yeah.
Capitol Hill and we go down Broadway. Does this all sound right?
Well, that's yeah, where okay. it always has happened.
Okay.
I think that's where the parade is.
I'm making this up as I go. But
well, the parade.
I'm lying to David and say, no,
I'm
it goes
thinking,
down Denny. And
I'm
then
thinking that I'm on Broadway tomorrow. And so anyway, we're marching down Broadway. It's the march, not the parade, because I actually have to fly back to California on Sunday, so I'm not part of the parade. But I'm
so
in
what's
march.
The difference between a march and a parade? I thought you because you march in a parade, but you don't parade in a march. Is that what it is?
Okay, so this is what I'm told is there for the march. There's no like they couldn't get a license for like motor vehicles, so I'm gonna like be in a rickshaw or something tomorrow.
Oh man, that's awesome. That's not right.
You know, rickshaw pulled by drag queens or something. I don't know. But anyway, it's going to be great. Whatever it is, it'll be great.
Just wow. I can't wait to wow. see it.
Come down to Broadway. I'll be there. I'll be waving.
Bad. I thought you were going to be like the big guy that gets you're in the back of the car. You're throwing candy to kids or whatever.
You know, I'm sure it'll be great.
Oh, that ain't
right.
You
know what I mean? I'm sure there'll be a, you know,
no motorized vehicles will be right. They'll give them a tricycle. Come on, Lincoln. Let's go,
sounds
buddy.
Sounds like a protest. Yeah. Lincoln, get on the Vespa. Yeah. Now let's go.
Lincoln, here's a bow and arrow. Get over there. Just do what we tell you, buddy. We don't get any cash.
Such a rickshaw. Put a new meeting to Chariots of Fire out there.
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah, yeah, all right.
Well, I don't know. Skates, maybe. Skates,
David,
skateboards, maybe.
You,
I don't know.
Now,
we'll
David,
see.
Now you don't have to answer this, but I mean, did you think at the time when they said, we'd like you to be the Grand Marshal, did you have the image of like the real pomp and circumstance, like the Macy's parade where you'd be like, I'm the guy?
I was imagining something with a motor. I don't know. But
this is wrong. Wow. This is a beating. That really, or they could carry you like those old sedan chairs that they had in Arabia.
Yeah, exactly. You know, exactly.
Like, which
exactly.
is, you know, not like pallbearers because you're still alive, but instead of carrying a casket, they carried a big chair you'd be sitting in.
I'm thinking thinking, actually, somebody said something about a segue last night, so maybe I'll be riding the segue.
That would be funny.
So
now you know, that would be Seattle, because we're all about like getting cars off the road here.
Excellent, excellent. Good plan. But yeah, show up tomorrow. I'll be riding on something. Somebody's back, maybe. I don't know.
How about that? Back. Well, hey,
great. Okay, Rev, there's no poops all around.
When
okay,
you poop, it comes down. And then it hits the ball.
Buddy.
Hits the ball.
What do you do?
All over the place. All over the place. Right here.
Oh, boy. How you doing, my boy? Hey,
I'm
you're
good.
A great guy.
I'm good. All right.
You might want to wash that shirt. There you go.
Get away from me.
The BJ Shea Morning Experience on 99.9 KISW.